My name's Colin. We're here at Parliament Buildings today reporting on the member of Youth Parliament Reception run by the British Council.
The MYP project, the UK Youth Parliament, is a project or a programme that is run by the British Youth Council, and it encourages youth participation at a local level within the UK. And this year was the first year that there was an election process as opposed to a selection process. So it allowed for more democratic representation of young people throughout Northern Ireland.
Why do you think it's such an important project in this year?
The MYP project is an important project in Northern Ireland because it encourages young people to engage more with each other, to be wider in participation, and it also builds community cohesion. It allows young people to be at the centre of decisions that are affecting them and allows them to elect people who will represent their issues and really give them a voice in different things that are going on within their communities.
What made you get involved with the MYP project?
Well, one of my teachers taught me about it, and I just thought it would be like a really good opportunity just to get involved with people from my area and make a change, hopefully.
Can you tell me a little bit if you supported your MYP?
Yeah, I got to meet Beth McDade today. It's the first time I've met her. She did very well and got herself elected for South Belfast. I'm really looking forward to having the opportunity to work with Beth, because I think there are issues that she wants to lobby on that affect young people in our constituency that I might be able to help her with. And together, we might be able to deliver some change.
Could you tell me about what level of responsibility do you think the MYP should have?
I think the MYP should stretch their job. They should be ambitious in their role. And so I'd feel quite comfortable if the MYPs were lobbying those of us who are here in Stormont or in Westminster, as well as getting out and about in the constituency and being seen publicly to speak up for young people in the constituency. So I hope MYPs will grow into their role and feel able to speak out loudly for young people.
Have you made any an impact in East Belfast there?
Well, I'd like to think I have, in terms of raising issues with representatives and working on projects with representatives. So hopefully in the coming months some of those things will come out and we'll be able to share them.
It's been really good to get to meet the MYP for East Belfast, Matthew, and I think he's got some great ideas on a wide range of issues, like education, for example, and youth services in East Belfast. We're exploring what ways we can maybe use online media to help young people find out more about the services that we have available to them in East Belfast.
Well, one of my manifesto points was about services for young people and mental health, so I would like to focus on those two because I think they're issues that are very overlooked in society today.
Have you got support from your local politicians around the way?
I've met with both Paul Maskey and Jennifer McCann, and I'm in continuous contact with them, so I have very strong support from them as well.
Was the election a hard fought election? Did you have much support from your family and friends?
There were four or five in my constituency alone, so I tried to get my school involved and to get my social groups involved as well, and it turned out to be a very good election. It's a very good experience.
How did you find the election process? Did you find it tough? Or?
Yeah, it was quite tough. Many sleepless nights organising different events and things to get elected in. But yeah, it was good. I enjoyed it.
Do you have much support of your local representatives?
Could have been more. There was a few who were really good, but then there was a few who didn't want to move.
This year has been a great success. I'm really glad that we got behind the project and that the British Youth Council have been so generous in supplying time, support and money to the Northern Ireland Youth Forum in running elections. It's a testament to how much young people want to be engaged in the decision-making process that they came out in such numbers. I mean, this is the first year that we've had elections, so to have 7,000 young people voting and to have 54 candidates really was quite amazing.